Welcome to this special edition of the Russell Brown Show, and I'm calling this show Extreme Printing. Now, when I say extreme, I mean printing outside the box. Because in this show, I'm going to take you to printing on wood, plastic, and metal, different surfaces that you've never tried before. Now, to do that, you have to have a special printer. And in this case, I'm going to show you my direct jet printer right over here in just a minute. But let's go through this story, because you normally print on paper, really high quality paper. But imagine if you could distress the surface. For example, in this case, where I'm using special compounds here from Golden, which allows me to then construct the surface of my printing. And by constructing it, I can give it a 3D texture. Check this out. Here's the whole workflow. It all starts with a blank piece of wood, in this case. And if you can look at this carefully, you can see that I have pre-printed on the surface a light coat of my image that I'm working with. Then, check this out. This is what makes this extreme. I have a piece of wood here, and if I angle this just right there, do you see that? Check out that texture. No. This texture is created in the real world, folks, with a little blade like this, a little palette knife, or with a brush. So, got that straight, you're creating your own surface, you texture it. Ladies, gentlemen, girls and boys of all ages, here, welcome to the Russell Brown Show of Extreme Printing. You can then print directly onto the surface as you see here. Check this out as I move this around. Do you see the texture? That's the texture that I created with the palette knife and the special compounds you can find at any art store. And then I place that into the printer. But wait, there's always more. Imagine you can send through any thickness of product through this printer. So what I really like is the ability to print on canvas. So typically when you print on canvas, you send a roll or the paper or canvas through the printer, a standard printer. But what if you could send the actual pre-stretched canvas through? Save time, and I'm into that. Just print directly on the surface and then texture your surface, once again, with some special compounds from the store. Different types of gels and heavy gels is what I used in this case. But there's even more. Let's say you don't want to put any compound or texture on and you just want to print directly onto canvas. Again, pre-stretched canvases go through this printer and you can print directly on them. That's pretty cool. So let's go over here to the printer right now and see how this process works. In this case, I'm using a Direct Color Systems Direct Jet printer. So check this out. In this case, I have a piece of wood over here. And I actually printed onto this piece of wood when it was wet, and so it cracked the surface. But if we come over here to the printer, and you can put this right onto the platen here, and the platen has sort of a sticky surface to it, so you don't really need to tape things down. And check it out, it then slides your printing materials through the printer at different heights. So I can change the height of the material that's going through the printer. And in this particular configuration with this printer, I'm using an Epson printer. It's actually built into this printer, so I'm using Epson inks, and so I can use the standard printing protocol here from the Mac or the PC when printing to an Epson printer, which is really, really nice. So you can see the different heights you can set over there and get great results. Now, there's even more to this whole process, because I'm going to show you some more close-ups of some other products here. So imagine you don't want to print on just standard 3D items. You might want to print on paper. Now, we can normally print on paper, but because devices like this are pin registered, the registration process is exact. You can go through, for example, and do what I'm calling progressive printing. So I print a base coat, as you see, Then, on the same piece of paper, and here in Photoshop, I might want to print another touch plate, I'm going to call it, in the prepress process terminology, where I want to touch the surface with a boost of green. Then I want to touch the surface with a boost of black. Now imagine, these are things you can't normally do with a single pass through a printer, but you can with a pin registered printer like this. And then what I love is to go back in with a touch plate of blue. Just really snap the blue in the image. And then your finished results look like this. You've achieved a progressive print that lets you add all of those different print processes into this final print. So you're creating a one-of-a-kind, unique print, something you can't just achieve by printing once through a standard printer. I call it progressive printing. It's amazing. Okay, let's now switch over here to Photoshop, because that's where it all begins. Check this out here on the screen. I'm going to start with that original image here that you saw. It's a light impression of the image that does not have all of the colors. Now watch as I turn on each of these individual layers, which represents each of the individual pieces of paper that I showed you earlier. They all add up to make the final result. Here I'm adding a touch plate of green. I'm using the term touch plate again because it's a term used in prepress where they lay in an extra boost of color. Here I'm adding in extra bump of the blacks, and here some more details of the gray values in the image. And I go through and add these one by one. They're going through the printer individually, each pass through the printer, and they're pin registered. And then finally, I said I really like to add these extra boosts of color, in this case, a little blast of blue and a little blast of this magenta. Now they seem really extreme here on the screen, but when they lay into the final print, they all add up to give you great results. So there we have it. Let's switch over here and show you the actual information about the printer that I'm using in this particular project. Again, it was a Direct Color Systems printer. You can go to their website, www.directcolorsystems.com, check out their printer, and see if you want to experiment with extreme printing. There you have it, another crazy show from the Russell Brown Show.